consumer, commercial, and industrial. In your view, which is the one that's moving the fastest, and where is it that, who is feeding on whom in this whole chain of use of IoT?
Sure, I think, you typically when you look at digital, and we've been talking about it a lot, there are three or four very critical use cases at a very high level. The first is when you're talking about consumer experience. And wherever you want to, have control over how your experience with the consumer is looking like, that's where, we are seeing a lot of consumer IoT come in. In fact, even if you're looking at, and I don't know how many of you are from the automotive industry, but, the automotive sales over a period of time is going to go down because, of the shared economy. And one of the conversations which is happening is that how do I make sure that once my car leaves the showroom, I can sweat my asset to bring in more service revenue. So when you start talking about consumer IoT, there are a lot of these kind of use cases which is happening. I think the biggest flip that I've seen in the last 6 months is actually on the industrial IoT side. And I think three areas where it's being applied a lot. One, we've already talked a lot extensively, is any industry which is asset heavy. So talk about energy, natural resources, industrial manufacturing, even for consumer companies, the production side of it. But I think two more use cases, places where we are seeing a lot of conversation happening, and actually we are doing projects also, is on the digital supply chain side. Okay. So if I was to take an example where we are working with one of the fragrance and flavoring companies out here. Now, if you typically look at flowers, which go into fragrances out here, that farm to the factory itself, that supply chain, when you're talking about a fragile thing like a flower out there, the wastage is immense.
Yeah.
How do I use something like an IoT on my supply chain to be able to track that, how does that entire thing move right from the farmers to my factory by minimizing the thing. The second that we are seeing is largely also on the agri and the horticulture side, where we are talking about in India where, 40% of my vegetable produce, 60% of my fruit produce, my, prawn sericulture and all of that goes waste out here. How can I make sure that apart from creating warehouses, I'm actually moving goods in a manner where I can get it to the market much, much faster. Mm-hmm. And I've seen that happen, actually crash from 3 days to 3 hours.
Okay.
Because of application of something like that. The third area that we are seeing a huge conversation happen is actually around the safety and manpower productivity. In fact, we have an offering for a client, we call it the Ghost Factory, where we are saying that, do you really need to open another factory? Or the one that you already have, I can run it more efficiently and add much, much more capacity to that factory itself. So taking an example, let's say you need three people to start a machine. After lunchtime, one guy comes at 1:10, the other comes at 1:20, the third one comes at 1:30. And where the machine was supposed to go up at 1 o'clock, you're actually having it go up at 1:30.
Right.
So can I actually reduce that? And then we did it for one of our clients. We were so surprised. Only 25% of the time of that manpower was productive. Okay. 25%.
Mm-hmm.
40% was actually going into effort for looking for the supervisor. And actually not even 40%, 30%. And 50 to 40% of the time was him taking a call, him going loitering around and all of that. Now that 40 to 50%, you can't get it to zero. He will have to take a break. He will have to, go and take a call. But then how can I get that 30 to 40%, which is that yellow area, much more productive? Mm-hmm. And how can I change that 40 to 50% to 20%, let us say that? So I think another third area, we've talked about asset management. We're talking about, so digital supply chain and manpower productivity side, where we're seeing a lot of these applications now starting to happen in the industrial IoT side.